Tonight's exploration is accompanied by Stone Angel Brewing's Red Setter Irish Red Ale. Pretty sure I've had this one before. It's just a got a nice ale taste. As they say, subtle toasted green and caramel notes with finishes of roasted dryness and a slight hop bitterness. Yep, nice and familiar, good beer. So tonight I'm going to be taking a closer look at these cheap power over Ethernet adapters that I got in the mailbag a few weeks back. Actually, they came out of a couple of different mailbags. They are very basic, and they sent me down a bit of a rabbit hole of exploration of power over Ethernet, only to discover that there's about four different standards. That's the great thing about standards. There's so many of them to choose from. But both of these sets operate based on the oldest possible standard. And because of that, they're only good for 100 megabit. They won't do gig. The first and most obvious clue to that is that there are only four wires actually wired out facing the Ethernet device. It's wire 1, 2, 3, and 6, otherwise known as pair 1 and pair 2. You can see on these ones as well, you can't actually see that the pins aren't populated, because they are. But you can see that it puts the DC on wires 4, 5, and 7, 8, reserving the Ethernet for the other four wires. And with only four wires, aka two pairs, you can only do 100 base T. You can't do gigabit. Let me show you a quick wiring diagram.
Here's just one that I found showing the different speeds of Ethernet over a Cat5 or Cat5e cable. If you're doing 10 base T or 100 base T, you need wires 1, 2, 3, and 6. So transmit positive and negative, or phase and in phase and out of phase, receive and receive down there, plus and minus. And you notice that wires 4, 5, 7, and 8 are not connected for that standard. If you move up to 1000 base T or gigabit, then you need pair data A, pair data B, pair data C, and pair data D.
So that is a quick strike against these devices here. However, if you're only doing 100 base T, with like for a webcam, or not a webcam, an IP camera or something like that, you don't need gigabit. You can get it away with 100 just fine. So that's what these things are really designed for. That's not the application that I wanted them for. The application that you see a lot of power over Ethernet done for these days is for powering a Wi-Fi hotspot or something like that, so you can just run a single cable to it, right? But that all aside, these ones I'm not going to be able to tear apart, but I will be able to tear apart these ones. So let's just grab a spudger and pop them open and see what's what. Huh? Is there a... Oh, ho, ho, you sneaky buggers. There's a screw hole underneath there. Okay. I mean, I guess that's good. It makes it a lot easier to open. Just like that. And here we have the little circuit board. The little circuit board with almost nothing on it. There's a couple jumper wires. There's a resistor and an LED and a little jack there. On this side, we see where going across there, wire going here to the jumper and to there, wire going there into the jumper and down to there, and wire going from there up to there. So that is the two data pairs. And then the power comes in over here. What is that? That's the resistor. It goes there to the LED. Where else does the power go? The power goes on to there, which is 2, 3, pin 4, and also across the pin 5. Then the other side of the power coming in here to pins 7 and 8. Right. Okay, so it is just completely basic and simple. Not much really to say about those devices, except that there isn't any way for them to do gigabit because they just don't have the wires. Although I remember in the comments when I pulled these things out of the mailbag, somebody said, oh yeah, you can do gigabit. No, no, you can't. The standard doesn't allow for it. And I can demonstrate that.
So here's my computer's connection to the internet. You can see that I am connected at gigabit speed to my Ethernet switch and then to my router and then out. So we'll run a quick Ookla test here. So I'm clearly connected at more than 100 base T. Otherwise, my ISP wouldn't be able to give me 250 megs down. Right.
And now we'll replace that connection. Well, use the same cable, but we'll insert one of these in. And yeah, I know. If you're OCD, don't look, all right? Then put the other half of the adapter pair onto this end of the same cable and plug that into the back of my computer, which I have to do by braille, so I can't show you what I'm doing, but trust me.
Well, there now you can see the computer recognizes this only as a 100 megabit connection, not as a gigabit connection. Everything else is the same. Do I need to hide any of that from you? No, that's all public information. And good luck trying to hack that IP address. Anyway, let's restart this test and you'll see that now with that adapter in, it can't do more than 100. So yeah, there you go. So for anybody in the comments from that last mailbag video who was saying, oh no, these things can pass gigabit.
So anyway, these do what they're supposed to do as long as you recognize the limitations of them. And that is your speed limitation. But they do, you know, connect DC connections onto the Cat5 cable that you've got in the wall and will run it to where you need it to be. So if you have a lower speed application for it, you can absolutely get some power there. I hope I didn't waste your time too much with that. I just wanted to explore these things and tinker with them a little bit and see what's up. And my curiosity is settled, so I hope that did something for you too. Thanks for watching. Questions and comments down below. Feel free to argue about the speed if you want, but I think I've proved my understanding to be correct. So there we go. Thanks for watching. Talk to you later.